This is very rare. I rarely start, but let me do it. Tonight, I am a deeply disappointed man. Because of the wave of violence witnessed at Kenol, Murang'a County, that could have been avoided. That two lives were lost and many other young people injured affirms one undisputed fact in our political environment that we never learn. Didn't I hear after the 2007-2008 post-election skirmishes that claimed over 1,000 lives and left thousands maimed or homeless, that never again shall lives be lost on account of political competition? I won't attempt to apportion blame. I hope that the security agencies will get to the bottom of the Sunday incident, identify, reveal, prosecute those who financed, incited, planned, orchestrated and perpetrated the chaos, their political standing and affiliation notwithstanding. But tonight, I want to speak to young men and women in this country. I am slightly above the 35 years age bracket, so I don't consider myself a youth. But be it as it may, time and again, young people have been the victims of political violence, as perpetrators and implementers of the violence. When police officers use violence to subdue rioters, the target of those bullets, live or rubber, and the copious amounts of tear gas are young people. But who do they really fight for and why? That young people died in 1992, 1997, 2007, and 2017 politically instigated violence is not in doubt. That more young lives were lost in Murang'a on Sunday is a sign of bad times ahead. But Stephen King, the American author, said, and I quote, "Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. Fool me three times, shame on both of us," end of quote. The Murang'a Sunday violence clearly pitted youths defending the two sides of the current political narrative, hustlers versus dynasties. Or should I say those fiercely defending Deputy President William Ruto against those allegedly hired and ferried to stop his tour of Murang'a County. But the truth is, the Murang'a combat was a hustlers versus hustlers contest. I did not see any son or daughter of the so-called dynasties throwing stones or lighting tires. But the two sets of combatants were fighting in defense of bigwigs and used by the same powerful forces. You know what? Very little is being talked about the two young men who died in Murang'a on Sunday. Yet their deaths won headlines for the big shots and offered a platform for the blame game between the two sets of powerful forces. And once the two youngsters are buried, so will their story. Only that their funerals will attract the same retinue of politicians for another dose of blame game. Once they are buried and forgotten, another bunch of youngsters will be lined up to fight each other, hate each other, and kill each other on behalf of their political masters, of course, for pennies that can't last them a day. Just how much is the worth of a poor young man's or woman's life in Kenya? And here is the sad part. The political fat cats being fought for have sons and daughters you will never see on the streets or losing their lives for political reasons. But these sons and daughters of the political masters who finance violence and pandemonium every so often feature prominently whenever mega scandals emerge. A look at the lists of directors in companies awarded billions in lucrative tenders rarely miss names of sons and daughters of top politicians being fought for. So how and why is it that poor young men and women will feature in the list of those killed or maimed in political violence, while sons and daughters of political bigwigs feature prominently in the list of mega beneficiaries of lucrative deals? Who is the fool here? You know, ours is a country of mafahali wachache na nyasi kwa wingi. And make no mistake, political settlement is at the top through handshakes and power-sharing deals, while political hate and violence is at the bottom. Last Saturday, I saw Deputy President William Ruto and ODM leader Raila Odinga at Nyayo Stadium exchanging pleasantries during the Kipchoge Keino Athletics meet. I didn't see them quarrel or refuse to talk to each other. Yet their supporters are fierce combatants, particularly on social media. In the run-up to the 2017 general election, supporters of President Uhuru Kenyatta and his then fierce competitor Odinga could not see eye to eye. The two leaders had not so kind words for each other. Kimodo, Muguruki, Mlevi, and so on and so forth. Yet months after the State House contest, they shook hands and now refer to each other as brother. Not forgetting the 2007 skirmishes that ended in a handshake and a grand coalition government between President Mwai Kibaki and Mr. Odinga. Yet in all these instances, very little is said about those who died, were injured, or lost property. So what am I saying? Brothers and sisters, young men and women, the wars you fight for are not yours. They have nothing to do with you. So go out there and fight your fellow youths if you want. But just know, the fruits of that tree watered by the blood of a young man or woman that you pour through political violence for just 500 bob or 1,000 shillings will benefit the very same bigwigs who pretend to be enemies, yet they sit in the same table, dining and whining together. That's my punchline.